मोटिवेशन ऑफ पावर, मोटिवेशन मेंस मच एंड मैक्स मोर। क्रेडिट स्टीलर वुड टेक ए बंडल ऑफ रॉटन एप्पल्स एंड पुट देम इन द ड्रॉर। आफ्टर दैट ही वुड गेट इंस्पिरेशन टू राइट समथिंग एल्स। व्लादिमीर नाबोकोव would keep his feet wet in order to get inspiration. As you know, Charles Dickens would comb his hair 50 to 100 times in order to get motivation. One day, it so happened, a teacher went to a senior class and wrote on the chalkboard the so-called longest word, New Manultra Microscopic Seal Icovolcanocoriosis. When he looked at the stones, all the stones were amazed, and he smilingly asked all the stones to count the letters of the word. All of a sudden, they told this word has 45 letters. He told the boys and girls to memorize this word, and the next day come prepared to write it on the chalkboard. The next day, the stones came. Only two students could easily write that particular word. So the teacher used a trick. He called a student of seventh class and told him to write that particular words on the chalkboard. He could easily write. After that, the teacher told the inspired students to write the same word next day on the chalkboard. What happened? The next day, 10 students would write. Again, he called a student of third standard, and the standard three student came and wrote that particular word on the blackboard. On the next day, what happened? All the students could write that particular word. That is called power of motivation. Start. Another day, another English teacher went to the class and told all the 15 students of that class to write the past tense of a bite and the past tense of a beat, B-E-A-T. Some students make mistake, like B-E-A-T past tense is B-I-T, B-I-T-E past tense is B-E-A-T. So he hit up a plan to tell them a very small story. He recounted, one day a Chinese boxer came to London to join in a boxing competition, and finally he was defeated. When he came back, his coach asked him, "What happened?" Now he beat me. Instead of telling beat me, B-E-A-T, he told B-I-T. So the teacher wrote on the blackboard B-E-A-T, past tense is B-E-A-T, B-I-T-E, past tense is B-I-T. So it became so amazing, so magical to the students that they could easily imagine and gave all their concentration to the class. So it is the duty of the class to motivate the students by means of bringing their concentration on the topic he is going to teach. One day, there is a book. The name of the book is Psychology of Power. In the Psychology of Power, the author has mentioned a very beautiful analogy. He called three persons and gave them a power gripper and told them to grip that power gripper to their utmost strength. What happened? All of them gripped 102 pounds. He told them to go away. The next day, again the three persons, same persons came, and he told them, before gripping the power gripper, he told them, "You look very feeble, you weak, you don't have that stamina." The three persons gripped only 80 pounds. Again he told them to go away. The next day, all the three persons came back, and he told them, "Today you look very smart, gorgeous. You look very handsome, you are very powerful. Today I think you can grieved much more than these previous day. So they all grieved 180 pounds. This is called power of motivation or motivation of power. This is what is called inspiration. So first of all, the teachers should inculcate the rules of inspiration in the minds of the students. So what will happen? Every student can prosper. So motivation means much and makes more. Thank you all.